Yo, remember back on the Bully when cats used to harmonize like. Yo, yo, my men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most the king. Yo, it's about a thing.
Feel real good. Wave your hands in the air
and lick two shots in the atmosphere.
Looking for your friend, the one you left and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? You act like you ain't him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you ain't even fooling him, if you did it then, and you probably can. Talking out your neck saying you're a Christian. I was slim sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna tell when the repercussions spin? Showing off your thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine.
Presented by Sprite, the 2K Sports pregame show.
It's 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson. Along with Shaquille O'Neal, the playoffs approaching and all eyes starting to look toward the postseason. Tonight, it'll be the Sacramento Kings up against the San Antonio Spurs at AT&T Center. Well, for San Antonio, they're going to be a factor when it comes to the postseason. Right now, they stand 5 games back from the conference leaders. Regular season winding down, the playoffs approaching for some teams, at least. What's the difference in a locker room between a team that knows it's going to the playoffs and another that's almost on vacation?
Well, no question, the playoffs are where you want to be, Ernie. For teams on the outside looking in, it's equalizing. You have to find ways to stay motivated and embrace the spoiler role.
Greetings, everyone, from San Antonio. The Spurs playing host to a Western Conference affair here at the sold-out AT&T Center. Thanks for tuning in, everyone, to this broadcast of NBA. Hey, basketball. I'm Kevin Harlan. With me today, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. The Kings would love to finish off this road trip on a good note. They are definitely a team in the bubble in the West, ninth place and vying for contention.
They've been playing a lot of basketball lately, Kevin. This is their third game in 4 days. The league didn't make it easy for them when they set up the schedule like this.
But I don't think it'll really have too much of a negative effect on them. But maybe the starting five won't play quite as many minutes as they usually do, but in terms of energy and endurance, I think they'll be fine.
Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. On the floor for Sacramento. They've got Rain Man. Warren is out there with Jimmy Butler. Then it's Ben McLemore. And it's O'Brien in at the five spot. Shumpert, no good. And Sacramento has possession. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
How about the box score from that game? The accuracy from the three-point line, just remarkable.
Yeah, it was a stream of threes that allowed them to repeatedly deflate that crowd.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Kevin, Greg Popovich and I got a chance to talk for a bit. He told me they'll be looking to stretch the opposing defense and open things up by using their ability to knock down long-range shots. Success from the perimeter will translate to success on the inside. Those were his words to me. Back to you.
Thanks, Doris. Always want to get those threes falling consistently.
Yeah, Kevin, you're right, because that's really the only way that you can force the defense to spread out and extend itself. And when that happens, then other opportunities are created.
Out of bounds, Kings ball as Sacramento keeps possession.
Yeah, so close to picking that pass off, guys.
At least he got a hand on it. He did what he needed to do to make sure it didn't hit the target.
And the shot by Warren, no good. Spurs have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Burks' shot is good.
Well, they just gave him 2 points. Defensively, you're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
Rain Man passes to O'Brien, stolen by Bosch. Right side jumper. Knight kicks to Burks. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Outside jumper. Fires the three. Butler with the block. To the inside. There's McLemore. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
Oh, Maestro, he is so good at making those lead passes, like conducting an orchestra.
Spurs have gone 3-5, shooting the ball so far. Knight picks to Young. Sacramento grabs the miss. And this game, the first chance they've had to see the San Antonio Spurs. That gives them the lead. Rain Man's got himself on the board with three there.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Right with it. Averaging 10 points per contest. Here's Bosch. Yes, and Knight with the assist that time. Bosch has got his second basket of the night.
Could be the first of many mid-range jump shots we see from him today.
And he gets the bucket.
Looks like he might be on his game today, Clark.
And San Antonio has possession. They trail by one. Fresh from a win against the Nuggets.
Yeah, it didn't seem to be much of a challenge for them in that game. It seemed like they scored at will. Not much defense that they were facing.
Yep, they had the defense on its heels early the entire game, and actually nearly the entire game, and no matter what unit was out there, looked like a mismatch to me.
The Kings have gotten 4 of 6 field goal attempts to drop in the first quarter. Here's Rain Man. He's guarded by Knight. Rain Man passes to Butler. McLemore dishes to Warren. Pass to O'Brien. Just 4 to shoot. And out of bounds. As San Antonio gains possession. And now the 2K leaderboard. If you want to talk defense and talk block shots, just have a look at these teams, what they've done the last month. In fourth, the Spurs.
They've been racking up the blocks lately. So, I mean, if they keep this up, they're going to be a very difficult matchup for anybody.
Now, here's Burks. A 14-point game for him in the win against Denver. Back tonight. Outside jumper. takes a three. Can't get it to go. Now Sacramento takes it the other way.
In this quarter, he's really been off the mark. He just looks a little bit unsettled.
Bosch grabs the miss.
Nobody near him. He'll normally make that one.
Fires the three. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. McLemore's got three rebounds so far in the game. Warren kicks to Butler. The dish to McLemore. Here's O'Brien. He's covered by Bosch. And O'Brien gets it to go.
Nice soft touch to drop that one in.
Spurs trail by three. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Knight kicks to Burks. Back to Knight. They need this one. It's rebounded by McLemore. McLemore's got his fourth rebound in this one. Now, here's Warren. Defense right on him. O'Brien. And he gets it to go.
And now we can see them really working it inside.
Taking advantage of the defense, really pounding it down low.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
You know, he understandably doesn't like what's going on out there, and that's why he wants to talk things over during this timeout.
I think this is a good time to call a timeout. They just need to hit pause for a second and then reset as well.
San Antonio making a switch here.
And now a look at Brandon Knight here. A breakdown since the All-Star break, averaging 9 points per game, 7 assists, and 2 rebounds. They've been able to count on him to run the show offensively, which he's done with his sensational passing.
Yeah, he's been setting them up with a lot of easy baskets. Room service dimes, we call them. One.
Oh, get it!
Oh, watch out now!
That's not as easy as he made it look, guys. You've got to have some skills to pull that baby off.
Well, he's got plenty of those skills necessary for
him. Oh, you know it. This guy can climb the ladder, can't he?
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
The Spurs making a switch here. Mills has checked in. The Kings also with the sub. Jeffries has checked in. And the layup is good. Jeffries got his first points of the game.
And yeah, they're moving the ball now. 8 of their last 10 points coming off assisted buckets.
Steve, nothing makes a coach smile as much as pure, selfless teamwork.
Well, you allow them to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
Yeah, I think you got to foul them, and free throws are better than the layup.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown so far for Sacramento.
They've been making some really nice passes out there. Excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And they're also showing some muscle here in the first half, finding a lot of points in the paint area.
Kyle Korver, he's checked in for Iman Shumpert. And he's good on the second. Sacramento leading by 5. Here's Rain Man. He's got 5. Mills with the rebound.
Right from the start, they've been aggressive on the glass. Most of the rebounds seem to be going their way.
And Steve, I think they are ready for the fight today. They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
That's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, Clark.
Butler attacking. Warren sets the pick for Butler. Another shot. Can't get it to go. Spurs trail by 3. Here is Korver. Burks dishes to Mills. He kicks it to Korver. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Got a piece of it. From 12 feet out, Jeffries with the rebound. Kings leading now by 3. Rainman passes to Butler. And there's the feed to Jeffries. That's good from 17 feet away. The Spurs have gone 6 of 14 shooting the ball since the start of the game. And here's Mills. He's coming off a 13-point game against Denver. The pass to Montgomery. 6 to shoot. From about 19 feet, shot's good by Mills. Mills has got his first basket of the night.
So the Kings call timeout. They're first.
Well, he wants to get everybody on the same wavelength, that's for sure. He may change up some things here as well.
Looks to me like he saw something that wasn't on the plan and picked now is the time to address it. I don't have a problem with that.
Tony Roten, he's checked in for the Spurs. Jeffries kicks to Ellis. And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. Spurs trail by 3. Here is Korver. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Mills passes to Montgomery. And Ellis with the block. Hines covered by Mills. Here's Jeffries. Passes it to Hines. It's Banks with the drive. Kicks to Hibbert. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Well, Sacramento, since the All-Star break, we get a look at the numbers they've put up here. 3rd in rebound, 7th in opponent field goal percentage. And they're in the top 10 getting into the passing lanes and coming up with steals.
And the rebounds really jump out at me, Clark, when you talk about all those numbers. I mean, this is a ferocious rebounding team. They're very physical, and they always take the fight to their opponent. They seem to own the paint, and when they do that well, they're awfully tough to beat.
The Spurs have gotten 7 of their first 16 field goal attempts to go down here in the first. 1:10 left to play in the first. Here's Roten, busts the J after the cagey pass fake.
You know, he's got a quick trigger from that range when he senses that the defense has backed off.
Here's Hines. You're looking at the list of the NBA's top shooters from behind the arc for the past month. 3rd is Tony Roten.
Sometimes a three-point shooter just finds that rhythm and it just seems to carry over. He's been hot for about a month now.
Feeds to Mills. There's the triple. Sacramento grabs the miss. 2-for-1 chance here.
Yeah, let's see if they use the clock to their advantage.
34 seconds left in the first. Count that one. Jeffries got 6.
He's not their first option, but not a bad fallback either.
Spurs trail by 5. Here's Roten. Hands it from downtown. Roten's got his 2nd bucket of the night. Sacramento's gone. Just 1-of-4 from 3-point range here in the first. And he gets it to go. And the Kings lead by 5.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Trading punches. That's how you answer.
Here's Mills. Right now averaging 11 points a game. Tries a 3 and a... Again, it's San Antonio with a 3. Just 4 seconds left to play in the first quarter.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
The Kings have gone 2-for-2 in the game at the line. Free throw good, Ellis. The Kings making a switch here. And so Monte Ellis nails both of them. The offense coming free and easy as we wrap up the first quarter. Kings lead by 4. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports.
Hey, Mr. Venner.
Tune in this Saturday night, April 1st. Giannis Antetokounmpo and the Milwaukee Bucks go up against the Boston Celtics. A battle in the East. Don't miss it.
Here we go. And the first quarter is in the books. Second about ready to get underway. And let's quickly break down the game we've been watching for the Kings, guys.
And they're really keying in on getting as many good shots inside the lane as possible. They're doing a nice job of not just settling for outside looks.
Yep, I agree. I mean, they're working it inside and doing it with intention and purpose.
On the court for the Kings as the second quarter gets underway. Ellis is out there at Crawford. Then it's Roy Hibbert. Then it's Rodman. And it's Hines and at the small forward.
Now, that's been a big part of their offense in the early stages. I mean, their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range right at the rim.
And I would continue to do it. You know, force the defense to maybe send a double team. Now you've got other options to work with offensively. Boy, I'm shocked he didn't make that one. He usually knocks that one down with ease.
Crawford dishes to Rodman. Crawford outside. Back to Ellis. Six to shoot. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Here's a look at some of the stats for Monte Ellis. Now the second half is shaped up for him. He's averaging 12 points, four assists, and two rebounds. And he's really been pulling his weight. I mean, we're finding his name in a lot of different columns in their box scores.
Yeah, and that's what they're looking for from him, Steve. He doesn't have to be the star, just somebody with solid contributions across a wide range of areas.
And that one falls for Monte Ellis. Sacramento making a switch here. He hits both from the stripe. And around a minute gone here in the second quarter. Knight against Rodman. Bosch, a screen on Buck. Roten, and he finishes nicely on the way. Roten's got 10.
You know, the defense didn't exactly try to fight around that screen, and that's why it turned into the easy basket.
They set the pick. Here's Butler. That one. Wide left.
Can't get a much better look than that, though.
Sure can't. Not one you'd expect him to miss there.
Sacramento foul.
The Spurs have shot two free throws, and they're 1-2 so far. And the first one drops. Alec Burks checked in for Roten. Sacramento also making some changes. McLemore's checked in for Crawford. And Rain Man subbed in for Ellis. Kings leading now by five. From deep, McLemore. And that is good. 7 points in the game.
You know, one aspect of their play today that's really been tight and far superior is their passing.
Agreed. I mean, you look at the points. I mean, they're getting a lot of baskets off of assists, so the offense really quick.
Bosch with the bucket.
It is so hard to contain him. He just seems to get it done however he has to do it.
Butler kicks to Rodman to the right side. Rodman sets a screen. Here's Rain Man. He's guarded by Knight. That savvy little up fake there. Fooling the defense. Rain Man's got the lead up to 8 now for the Kings. For San Antonio, they've gone 2-3 from the field here to open the second quarter. Bosch hits the pick for Burks. And play stops. Whistle on what looks to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, good call there. You could tell he was moving into the defender when he tried to set the screen.
Yeah, lowered that shoulder, dipped right into him, too. I mean, he was going to be called on that foul either way.
Warren's checked in for Dennis Rodman. Bosch, the screen. The drive by Shumpert. Burks kicks to Young. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. And he's got his first free throw of the game. That free throw good from Thaddeus Young.
Thaddeus Young.
Off on that one, so he goes 1-for-2 at the line.
They've been getting more and more physical as this game has gone along.
Clearly. And they've gotten a lot of trips to the line because of it here in the second quarter.
Now here's McLemore, guarded by Shumpert. Shot clock at 6. McLemore, the pass to O'Brien. That misses off the backboard. Spurs trail by 7. Young dishes to Shumpert. He feeds it to Burks. Pass to Bosch. Left side, Bosch. Got a piece of it. Out of bounds, Sacramento takes possession.
Looking at the Kings over the last month, let's see how they stacked up in the league statistically. Second in rebounding, sixth in three-point field goal percentage. And they're in the top third in the league in blocks. They're a team that really doesn't give many good looks.
Yeah, I agree with you there, Clark. And what jumps out to me is the rebounding, because when you can rebound the basketball as a team, you can stay in every game. Even if you're not shooting the ball well, you rebound, you get extra possessions, and you allow your team the ability to make a comeback.
The Spurs have gone 3-4 from the floor here in the second quarter. Knight kicks to Shumpert. Back to Knight. And he uses the glass on the layup. Now just a three-point Kings lead.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively, Park. I mean, what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
They've been outstanding from three-point range in this quarter.
The Spurs have gotten four of their first five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooting. Burks can't get it to go.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
McLemore, the pass to Butler. At the elbow, it's Warren. Here's Rainman. The three-pointer is right on target. And it's a 9-point Kings lead.
The D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been of the three-point variety.
Yeah, and unless they make some rotations and closeouts defensively, there's more to come. But just seems like they're finding an open lane to the hoop every time down. There's five buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
The Kings making a switch here. Jeffries has checked in. Here's Rain Man. He's guarded by Knight. Dishes it to McLemore. Here's Warren, and there are the Kings with another bucket.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
Butler against Knight. Right side jumper. Bosch kicks to Knight for the three. Jeffries with the rebound.
Solid job by them on the glass here tonight. +8 in rebound.
Well, you have to rebound to win, and that's exactly what's happening right now.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Well, they already had him staggered, and now all of a sudden they're throwing some haymakers.
Butler against Knight. There's the double team with Warren. Here's Shumpert. Burks in the corner. Knight dishes to Burks. Just five on the clock. And that one's good. Burks has got 4 points now in the quarter. And Sacramento has possession. And out of bounds as San Antonio gains possession. As we close in on the start of the playoffs, let's see how the West is stacking up. You look at San Antonio. Right now they're locked into third place in the conference, looking to get a high seed for the playoffs. And, of course, the Sacramento Kings. Right now quite a ways down below.
You know, checking out San Antonio, they've really caught nobody by surprise this year. I mean, they've got a tremendous track record and the talent to stay on top for a while.
Yeah, and you know, some people wondered if there'd be a drop-off this season just because of those high expectations, but there really hasn't been a drop-off at all. Almost surprised that he had that much room to work with.
Spurs trail by 9. 13 feet away. Yes, and Knight with the assist that time. Burks has got 11 points.
8 of the last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint.
Man, it's not necessarily strategic, Clark. It's just a matter of playing with more heart. Got to play hard, guys.
Butler passes to Jeffries. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. He's got 10.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but their cutting, their movement together as a unit that's led to that.
San Antonio calls timeout, so San Antonio goes with a fresh five on the floor. The Kings making a switch here. Let's bring up the 2K leaderboard to see which teams have been the best in the rebounding department since the All-Star break. The Kings in third.
Boy, they've gotten a fresh start since that break, Kevin. They're like a new team when it comes to rebounding the ball. They've gotten charged up and revved up to rebound. Hard work on the glass once again, fellas. They put a lot of effort into their rebounding.
Well, you get more rebounds, you get more possessions, more shots at the hoop, and oftentimes that decides the game.
Spurs trail by 11. Roden kicks to Mills. Pass to Montgomery. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down. I like that they're taking it inside and taking advantage of each opportunity, Clark, to chip away at the deficit.
Yeah, and doing it with the dunk is a major energizer, too. Gets the momentum going.
Yeah. I think the interior defense did as good a job offensively as we saw. The defensive presence was almost non-existent. And they may see this lead disappear if they continue to give up those easy points.
The dish to Mills. Good on the three-point shot. Mills has got 5 minutes.
Yeah, and he had to get that shot off quickly because the defense was all over him.
Yeah, that's the key, Steve, the quick trigger. Any hesitation, and that shot gets blocked.
Here's Rayman. Cans the shot with nobody near him.
You know, it seems like when they've gone to him, he's really come through. And that's not something they should get away from.
San Antonio's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Now Mills. 5 points in the game. He dishes it to Korver. Shoots off the screen. Rebound by the Kings. Jeffries got 4 rebounds now tonight. Hines the pass to Jeffries. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And the free throws for him this year, he's making them at about a rate of 77%.
Spurs trail by 10. And Tony Roten gets the whistle there. That's foul number 2 for him.
Great defense. He anticipated the play and got there first.
Yeah, I think he got there in time. Nice play.
Here's Tucker. He's covered by Aminu. Rayman passes to Jeffries, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Threw it down with authority.
Oh, he can really fly. And you combine that, Clark, with some of the nice penetration, too, and you've got an easy 2 points.
Yeah, that's good stuff there. He's able to play well above the rim, but the execution really got him that look.
Mills with it. To the left wing, Aminu dishes to Korver. Now, here's Aminu. Shot is blocked. McLemore, the pass to Rayman. Right wing. And McLemore kicks to Jeffries. And there's a nice one-handed slam.
Maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that.
And we know he's capable of those memorable dunks.
But you know, they've got a nice lead. Don't take any chances. The simple one-hander is just fine. There's no way you can get back into the game if you continue to give up layups.
Here's Mills. No good. A dominating first half of basketball, and so far hasn't been close. Kings ahead, up by 16. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Coach, you're going to have to climb a bit of a hill here in the second half. What are you telling your guys they need to do to turn this thing around?
I think we just moved the ball a little bit. We were just on the dribble a little bit too much, and there got a lot of pressure out there, so the ball's got to move.
Coach, thanks for the time. Gentlemen, back to you at the table.
All right, Doris, thank you, and we'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter. as we begin the second half. First half wasn't even close, guys, and we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third quarter started. Young is out there with Chris Bosh. Then there's Amon Shumpert. Then there's Brandon Knight. And it's Burks in the shooting guard position. So that's who Greg Popovich starts the second half with. Now, here is Knight, guarded closer. Outside jumper. Out to the right wing. Clock at six. Now, here's Burks. Defended by Butler, and he's able to get it back. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. Kings leading now by 16. He kicks to McLemore. And it's blocked by Bosh. Now, here is Knight, guarded closer. There's the feed to Burks. To the left side wing. Bosh dishes to Knight. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Sacramento's gone 5 of 9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Now here's McLemore. He's covered by Bosh. Here's O'Brien. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Yeah, the defender draped all over him.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
The Kings have shot 6 of 7 at the line. That one is no good. Spurs trail by 17. Burks the pass tonight. Just over a minute and a half played here in the third. The pass to Burks. Releases. That one off the back iron and out.
It's been a great day for them on the boards, Clark. That's definitely been a major factor in building this big lead.
And, you know, from a number standpoint, the advantage might not be that large, but they have been manhandling them inside.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all alone for that shot. It was a warm-up jumper.
The Spurs have gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second half.
Boy, he wants to get everybody on the same wavelength, that's for sure. He may change up some things here as well.
Looks to me like he saw something that wasn't on the plan and picked now as the time to address it. I don't have a problem with that.
San Antonio calls timeout. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Kevin, Greg Popovich was just going over the plan with his team. He told his guys to make sure they keep the pace fast, to get out and run each and every chance they get. He also asked for a very strong effort on the offensive glass. He wants to see them cashing in on a lot of second chance opportunities. Well, they need to make something happen before the start of the fourth quarter, and maybe those changes will do the trick, Kevin.
And as always, Doris, thank you.
Let's see how the Kings have performed over the last few weeks. Second in rebounding, fourth in blocks. And they also show up as a top 5 three-point shooting team. I mean, that's tall cotton there. Elite level marksmanship from behind the arc.
Yeah, I agree with you there, Clark. And what jumps out to me is the rebounding, because when you can rebound the basketball as a team, you can stay in every game. Even if you're not shooting the ball well, you rebound, you get extra possessions, and you allow your team the ability to make the comeback.
And Young, here we go.
And now let's take a look at Alec Burks' numbers. A breakdown since the All-Star break. He's averaging 12 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. I'm sure he's happy with the way things have been going. Those are some nice, steady numbers.
Well, how could he be unhappy about them, Steve? I mean, he'd probably like to see just a little more of an uptick in them just the same, but nothing to not be content about there.
All free throws good from Thaddeus Young. Kings leading now by 16. Passes it to Raymond. Outside Butler. Kicks it to Warren. Pass to O'Brien. Red ball movement here by the Kings. The shot by Butler. Nobody around. Butler can't get that one to fall. Shumpert against Butler. And it's Shumpert penetrating. And Young with the basket on the assist by Shumpert. Young's got five now.
Brought back the finger roll. That's a nice finesse move to pull off with the defense all over it.
Butler passes to O'Brien. Back to Butler. 9 feet out. Jump shot is good. He has seven.
Now they got the most out of that possession, guys.
Butler against Knight. Bosch, a screen on Butler. And Young, here we go. And Shumpert kicks to Bosch. And the call will be against Thaddeus Young. That's his first foul. Ellis is checked in for Sacramento. Butler in the corner. Pass to Raymond. There's the pass to O'Brien. 8 feet away. That's good. O'Brien's got 5 points now in the quarter.
My, he is so adept at finishing in the low post.
Spurs trail by 18. And here is Knight. Six on the shot clock. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
Sacramento foul.
And you love the concentration. Gets hit, but stays with the play.
Yeah, he showed a lot right there. Plenty of concentration finding a way to get that shot to fall.
Some changes for Sacramento. Roy Hibbert's checked in for O'Brien, and Banks is subbed in for Rainman. And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Kings.
Well, the great passing we saw in the first half has carried right over into the second.
They've also jumped on any opportunity they've had to attack the basket tonight. I mean, excellent penetration.
Ellis dishes to Butler. Hibbert against Bosch. That's a two from Butler. Knight grabs the board.
He has yet to get into the flow of this game. His teammates have done their part, but they need him to pick his game up.
Burks. Great D that time from Hibbert.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady work they've been doing. Interior, no question, and that's I think the main reason they have this lead. And it seems like nothing is falling for him this quarter. He's really out of his rhythm.
Bosch passes to Shumpert. Feeds it to Young. San Antonio again missing. Dishes it to Knight. Looks for Bosch, gets it to him. Second shot opportunity. That's good. The assist that time from Knight. Knight's got his seventh assist here tonight. Now a timeout called by Sacramento. So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Here on the 2K leaderboard of the NBA's leading defensive teams since the All-Star break. Number 5, the Spurs.
Yeah, I think the coaches really challenged this club at the break to improve their defense, and that's exactly what they've done.
Now here's Butler. He's tightly guarded. Hibbert kicks to Banks, and the wide-open shot from Warren. That three off the mark. Spurs trail by 13, and there's a foul. It goes on Jimmy Butler. That is his first foul of the game. So Greg Popovich going to take a timeout right here and talk to his team. The Kings making a switch here.
Jeffries. Hines. Rayman.
Here's Aminu, averaging 9 points per contest. To the left wing, Mills passes to Montgomery. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back.
Well, he wasn't fazed at all by the bigger man on him, and on the low block, I thought he might be.
You know, Steve, I thought maybe he'd prefer to bring him out to the perimeter, but whatever works, go to it.
That's been a great day for him, and if you remember, he gave them a huge performance their last time out as well.
Spurs have gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime, 5 out of 11. The dish to Aminu. Great tee that time from Hibbert.
Well defended, and he's not someone who responds well to that kind of defensive pressure.
Hines, the pass to Raymond. He feeds it to Jeffries. Passes it to Hines. Clock at 4. Hibbert kicks to Jeffries. And that is good. Jeffries got 18 points in the game.
Good job threading that pass into the lane. I like his vision, guys. He sees everything.
The feed to Roten. Shumpert in the corner. He dishes it to Aminu. Back to Shumpert from deep, but he stays with it. Good on the three. Three-point shot. He's got 6. Kings leading now by 12. Here's Rain Man. He's got 14. To the wing right side. Here's Hines. They grab their own miss. Kicks it out to Banks. 1:51 left in the third quarter.
Good.
16 points for Rain Man.
And their interior defense getting exposed once again. How many open looks at the rim are they going to allow?
And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back.
A chance here to see how the Kings rank in the NBA right now. Second in blocks, 5th in field goal percentage. And they're in the top 10 getting into the passing lanes and coming up with steals.
Man, Clark, let's talk about those blocks, because you know what that does? When you're a guard and you've got great shot blockers behind you, it allows you to play with more aggressiveness on the perimeter, and that can really disrupt an offense.
1:21 left to play in the third. Now Mills. He has 5. Montgomery, the pass to Aminu, and he gets it to go. Aminu's got 5 now.
Superb assist there. He played the role of the maestro on that one.
Hibbert with the screen. Pass to Hines. Outside Banks. He kicks it to Jeffries.
So now an opportunity to look at some of the stats on Patty Mills. His last 10 games, he's putting up about 12 points per game, 4 assists, and 2 rebounds. And no doubt about it, he knows how to run the offense and really not miss a beat when he comes off that bench.
Steve, you are an NBA guard. Not a lot of guards can do that coming off the bench, but he is one of them that can.
Here's what Sacramento's going with right now. Rodman comes in for Roy Hibbert, and it's Crawford in for Banks. Here's Mills, Rodman covering. Kicks to Korver, shoots it up. Can't hit. Now Sacramento takes it the other way. They led the game at 1 point by 20. Rodman sets a screen. Crawford dishes to Jeffries. Hines the pass to Rodman. And out of bounds as the Spurs gain possession. Chris Bosch has checked in for San Antonio.
13 seconds on the shot clock. 13. In for your Spurs.
Spurs trail by 17. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Rain Man. That'll be his second foul of the game. 26 seconds left in the third. Here's Roten. Dents the rim with a two-hand slam. Wow. That could give him a huge injection of energy, Clark.
And Kevin, that's exactly what they need right now. They've got to close the gap.
Forget about that for a second. How about the burst to the bucket for a point guard? Boy, he can power those down.
They set the pick. Crawford kicks to Jeffries. Plays it up and banks it in. Jeffries got six here in this quarter.
Yes, sir.
Just 4 seconds left to play in the third. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Kings lead by 17. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports.
Playoff spots hang in the balance. Joakim Noah and the Chicago Bulls take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. This weekend, NBA action.
Spurs trail by 17. And a look at the five for the Kings to start the fourth. They've got Warren. Ellis is out there with McLemore. Then there's Jimmy Butler. And it's O'Brien in at the five, roaming the paint. And that one's good.
As long as they keep spraying them from deep, we're going to have ourselves one exciting finish.
Well, it took them a while, but they're finally starting to get some rhythm offensively on the outside.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. Terrible turnover.
And San Antonio shooting well. 50% from the floor. And it's Bosch in the corner. Puts one up from 19. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be. Firmly in control of this game.
Yeah, they have not let their guard down one bit in the paint. Boy, great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, it sure was. He made a beeline for the bucket as soon as they got the ball. Right away, straight to the rim.
Fourth quarter, still young, just over a minute play. Knight with it. Pass to Bosch. Back to Knight. Shot clock at six. Feeds to Bosch. Lets the three fly. Bosch can't get that one to fall.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Yeah, they're lucky that they didn't get burned on that one.
Here's the screen. Back to Ellis. All sorts of time. To the wing on the left. Goes back up. Shot's good by McLemore. And the Kings lead by 18.
Great looking bounce pass to set up that play.
Now, here's Burks. Outside Bosch. Burks' shot is good.
I don't know who was supposed to be on him there, but clearly a mistake by the defense.
Ellis goes in. Out to the right wing. Now here's McLemore outside. A rebound by the Spurs. They can look forward to the American Airlines Center after this game. They'll match up against Dallas. That one will start off a three-game road trip for the team.
Some good matchups. And that Dallas Mavericks game, definitely one to be checking out.
Aminu with the bucket. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Butler on the wing, defended by Young. Over in the corner, Warren. Right wing. Now here's McLemore outside. Thaddeus Young grabs the miss. Young's got six rebounds here tonight. Here's Bosch. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Bosch has got 9 points here in the second half. Kings leading now by 11. And here is Butler. There's the pick. Over in the corner, Warren. And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. San Antonio's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. And Young kicks to Knight. Now the pass to Burks. Ice ball booming by San Antonio. Shot clock at six. Young. And another basket for San Antonio.
And
they have gotten themselves back into this game just in the nick of time. If that run had come any later, it would have been too late.
But they're not all the way where they need to be yet, Steve. They've got to keep pushing through.
Ellis kicks to Butler. Warren sets the pick for Butler. Off the pick. That's good.
Despite his ineffectiveness, the team has found other scoring options, which you have to have when one of your main guys is struggling.
Spurs trail by 11. Here's Knight. Dishes to Bosch. Here's Aminu. Sacramento grabs the miss. McLemore's got his fifth rebound in this one.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Ellis can't get it to go. The Spurs have gone 5-8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. And that's a foul called on T.J. Warren. San Antonio making a switch here. Shumpert's checked in. Rain Man's checked in for the Kings. Now, here is Young. Not a lot of room. The drive by Bosch. And, there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup. And while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call a foul shot or not. But sure enough, they have. So he'll head to the free throw line. Sacramento making a switch here. Kings leading now by 9. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. It's going to go on Alec Burks.
It's been a tough go for him. Just an uncontainable game for Rain Man. 16 points, and he's hit the mark twice from three-point range as well.
Well, it's no secret. I mean, the more points he can come up with from out there, the better off they'll be offensively with their spacing.
Knight on the wing. There's the dish to Shumpert. Lots of room. And it comes off the front of the rim.
Well, I think he was surprised by how much space he had there and just rushed the shot a little bit.
Butler attacking. Here's Rain Man. He's guarded by Knight. Now here's McLemore outside. Sacramento again missing. Spurs trail by 11. Young sets a screen for Knight. Young outside. Now, here is Knight, guarded by McLemore. Young with no one around. San Antonio again missing. The Kings have gotten only 3 of their 9 field goal attempts to go down since the end of the third. Pretty cold down the stretch. Here's McLemore. Gets the 14-footer to fall. And the Kings lead by 13.
And they have to mix it up defensively. That was just too easy.
Knight kicks to Bosch. Lets it go from deep. And that one's good. Bosch has got 10 points now just in this quarter.
Well, you know, he has shot the ball well, but it has not been contagious. And his teammates, they haven't had the same groove, and that's why we're looking at this result so far.
Tucker dishes to Butler. In the corner, it's McLemore. Here's Hines. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Man, they are spreading the floor and letting it fly, really knocking it down from outside.
And I love that gunslinger's mentality, Steve. Playing to win as opposed to playing it safe. I call it prevent offense when you try to protect the lead. Let it fly, let it fly, let it fly.
And that's an intentional foul.
I'm not sure what he was thinking about there. That's a strange foul. Third team foul.
Who knows? Maybe he just wanted to. Take a break for a minute.
An 8 rebound. Advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference.
McLemore, the pass to Tucker. He feeds it to Butler. The rebound by Young. Young's got 7 rebounds in the game. Shumpert gets a wide open look. No good on the triple.
Really good offensive execution. Nice pick. Just couldn't get the shot to go.
Boy, you love to see that as a basketball purist. Guy setting a good three and then getting the shot opportunity.
A free run to the hoop and some thunder on the finish.
Not exactly the way the D would have drawn that one up.
And when you got the space, you might as well throw it down. That's what I always used to do.
Young from outside, and they will call over the back on the play.
Well, he gave the officials no choice there. Easy call, went right over the top.
Yeah, he's got to go straight up when he's on the... the boards in that kind of traffic. Can't chest first into the man in front of you. That's a foul.
They set the screen. The kick outside to Butler. Now here's McLemore outside. Passes to Warren. Here's Rain Man. Pass to O'Brien. Here's McLemore. Good! McLemore's got 6 points in the quarter.
That is a terrific effort on the shot. He's giving up a lot of size, but still finds a way to score.
I don't think that affected him in the least, though, Steve. I mean, he made it look like he was the bigger guy.
San Antonio calls timeout. They're losing by 17. 1:56 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Bosch, double teamed. 1:51 left in the fourth quarter. On the wing, Shumpert. To halt the run, and he gets the bucket.
And that kind of defense is just not going to cut it. Guys, they have to get a hand in his face.
Kings leading now by 14. Here's Rain Man. Butler in the corner. 6 to shoot. Here's Rain Man. Trying to answer back, but that 3 is off the mark. San Antonio's gone over and over to the 3-point shot in the fourth quarter. 4 of 9. Out to Shumpert. Beyond the arc. Sacramento grabs the miss. They led the game at one point by 20.
Boy, they've really won the battle of the boards in this one, Kevin.
And so only one team answered the bell tonight. Not a monster blowout by any means, but still a double-digit victory for Sacramento.
In the end, they had a better shooting percentage, and that's what made the difference. Sometimes, you know, Clark, things go your way. The other team wasn't catching any lucky breaks themselves.
Well, it's more than luck, Kevin. I think the shot selection was good, too.
And so it'll boost this year's win total for them to 29.
And looking at the arc of the season, this is the first of 2 meetings on the year, so this will be a solid win to go up 1 zip in the season series against the Spurs.
Timeout called by the Kings. They're up by 16. There's 39 seconds left in the fourth quarter, so both teams changing it up here. Jeffries kicks to Hibbert. Sacramento moving it around. Butler attacking. Now the feed to Jeffries. Takes the 13-footer, can't get it to go. And San Antonio will go the other way with it. Kicks to Aminu. 2-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Pass to McLemore. Here's Rain Man. He dishes it to Jeffries. Right through the D for the layup.
Jeffries.
And the Kings lead by 18.
And the crowd here, of course, not happy about the outcome. But you know what? We saw a team tonight that came in prepared to do battle on the road, and they clearly wanted the win.
You know, they were determined to steal this game, and they showed it, Steve. Played harder and got the job done.
So it's the Kings winning this one easily. And this one was such a lopsided victory.
They never let up. They were full throttle from the start.
And now for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for joining us tonight in our presentation of NBA on 2K Sports. Now our Jordan Player of the Game.